Hey, what's up? John Sonmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. So, I've got an email here. It's a really long one. I'm actually really not going to read this full email, but I'm going to give you some highlights on this this email. So, starts off, I started watching your videos on YouTube where I heard about this blogging course. I started a blog at the beginning of December and have come to realize the benefits of a blog by writing to it regularly. If you're wondering what he's talking about, it's my free course on creating a blog to boost your career. Like, I think, gosh, like 5,000 developers or so, maybe more than that, have gone through it now. Probably more, probably closer to 10,000 developers. Anyway, check it out. It's totally free. You just sign up. And then he says, before starting it, I would stubbornly refuse your point about specialization, right? See, I talk about this all the time, and everyone always says that. But after making consistent posts on it, I have to concede. I now clearly see the benefits of being a specialist. I do enjoy blogging and find it helps me learn information, so I'm thinking about starting multiple blogs. This is where I'm not going to read the rest of this. But he goes on to say, my primary blog will be about, and by the way, I'm not making fun of you, you know, I'm just using this as an example, because this is a good example. My primary blog will be about me learning Ruby on Rails for web development. My secondary blog, you know, he has a paragraph about that one, will be about books. He says he's an avid reader. He says my tertiary blog, if you have to use tertiary blog, that's a problem, will be my current blog, and I don't plan to spend too much time on it. So he basically wants to know, how should he do this? And I've got an answer for you, which is don't do this. You're spreading yourself way too thin. Like, keeping one blog up to date, like writing one blog post a week, is tough enough, right? And the thing is, like, you know, with this whole technique, with this whole idea of building a reputation and a brand, it takes a lot of energy and a lot of focus, and it takes a lot of time. And if you spread yourself thin over multiple areas, what's going to happen is you're going to be diverting that focus, right? It's going to be not as concrete. It's not going to be as potent, right? You're going to be going out in multiple areas, and not only are you going to burn out, because you will. There's no way you're going to keep up three blogs. You're not going to do it. You're not going to keep them going. But you'll be like, the whole idea of the specialization, the whole idea of the personal branding that I talk about, you know, in my How to Market Yourself as a Software Developer course. I'm assuming you've probably taken that if you're talking about this. But the whole idea is that you've got to be known for something. You've got to be identified for something. You've got to have some kind of a specialty. People need to be able to say, hey, you're that guy, right? So, you know, for software developers, people say, hey, John, you're the soft skills guy for software developers. Okay, yeah, or the life coach, whatever. You know, it's a specific thing. You don't want to be like three different brands. It's hard enough to build one brand. Don't divert your energy. And this is just a good lesson in life in general, I think, is that, you know, you're going to focus, like, go deep in one area. Don't, you know, it's okay to diversify to some degree, but you got to have one primary area where you're going deep and you're pushing hard in order to make progress. When you're going in multiple directions at the whole time and you're spreading your energy out, right? I did this video on investing. I talked about how to retire early, and I talked about the idea that I don't like the idea of putting in your 401k and trying to invest in real estate, because you're going two different directions, right? You're splitting your focus. Pick one path. You know, are you trying to retire early or late? Pick one path and go down it and put your full energy into that path. It's the same thing in a lot of areas of life and software development. A lot of people, where they fail, again, I did a video on halfway burning the boat, right? When you're halfway to burn the boat. If you're gonna burn the boats, burn the boats. But the worst possible thing that you could possibly do is light the boat on fire and then get in it and then try to sail away. That's just stupid, right? But so many people do that. And that's what you'll be doing if you create three different blogs, is you commit to one, burn the boats, go down that path, and commit to that path. But if you try to go down multiple paths at the same time, you're trying to leave these doors open for you, it's gonna end in disaster. You're not gonna make any real progress down any one of those paths, and you're gonna regret it. So trust me, you know, you're on the right path. You're doing the right thing by starting your blog, but don't go and say, this is working so great, so I'm gonna do two more of them. No, not until you're super successful at one and you can hire a team to create other blogs and a writing staff and all that. Then you can diversify and go that direction. So Anyway, hopefully you find that useful and not too condescending. I'm not trying to beat up on you, buddy, here, but I do want to give you, you know, some valuable advice. So if you have a question for me, email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And if you like this video, subscribe. Talk to you next time. Take care.